At HPA, we use the Peel 3 3D scanner, and it's great for motorsport design, but at about $9,000, it is out of the budget for most enthusiasts. Most of the product-specific questions we get on 3D scanners are in the sub-$1,000 price range. So today, we're going to be looking at the performance and usability of four scanners in this price range. More specifically, we've got the 3D Maker Pro Moose, we've got the RevoPoint RANGE 2, the Creality CR Scan Otter, and the Shinning 3D EINSTAR. The reason for choosing these four scanners is we wanted to be able to take larger scans, so the exterior of a vehicle, for example, or things like engine bays, but it is still good to have the versatility to be able to scan smaller, more detailed parts as well. And the reason for choosing the sub-$1,000 price range is so it's more accessible at the enthusiast level. So let's take a closer look at each of these options. So first up, we've got the 3D Maker Pro Moose, and this comes in at only $700, making it the cheapest scanner we've got on our test. This has by far the smallest capture range or field of view, and also working range or depth of field of the scanners on test, which I think is going to give it a little bit of a limitation in terms of scanning efficiency. This is a blue structured light scanner, and it quotes a really high accuracy at 0.03 millimeters. So next up we have the RevoPoint RANGE 2, and this comes in a little bit more expensive at $800, and this quotes the lowest accuracy of the scanners we have on test at 0.3 millimeters. Then we have the Creality CR Scan Otter, and this comes in at $900 and quotes the highest accuracy of the scanners on test at 0.02 millimeters. Finally, we have the Shinning 3D EINSTAR, which seems to be getting the most attention on the market at the moment. This is $1,000 and it quotes an accuracy of 0.1 millimeters. The RANGE 2, the Otter, and the EINSTAR are all infrared structured light scanners and have huge capture areas and working ranges, so they should be able to capture data really efficiently. All of these scanners work on either Mac or Windows. We'll be doing the test with a Mac today, and this computer is up to the recommendations of all the scanners except for the EINSTAR, but from some prior testing, it all seems to be working okay. So let's jump into some head-to-head comparisons. We're going to do two scans today. One is going to be a more detailed scan on an engine block, and one is going to be a larger scan on the exterior of an RX-7. Alright, so let's start with the 3D Maker Pro Moose. So the first thing to note is that you need to plug it into a power source and also your laptop, so you've got a few cables to work with. The next thing is that there's not actually a start and stop button on the scanner, so you need to reach across and do it on your computer, which is a bit of a pain. There's also no way in the software to just pause and then resume your scanning, so you basically need to take multiple scans and merge them together. Or if there is a way of doing this, it's not intuitive. Which really brings me to the software itself. It does seem to be lacking some tools, and it isn't really clear and easy to use. The whole product as a whole seems to be quite cheap compared to the other scanners, even down to the point that it just arrives in a box rather than a case. So when it came to scanning the engine block, it initially seemed to scan quite well. However, the very small field of view means the scanning is inefficient and we have to move around the object quite a lot. However, errors did start to creep into the scan. As I moved back and forward, I'd notice that holes that I'd previously scanned no longer lined up. This was somewhat fixed with the post-processing, but the initial post-processing itself is really slow. After this, the point fusion and the meshing processing is actually pretty quick though. Other than that, the blue structured light just doesn't seem to work well on dark surfaces, and any black components just weren't getting picked up. So when it came to scanning the RX-7 with the Moose, it was really just a waste of time. With such a small field of view, it basically sees the same frame over and over with such simple geometry and no geometric features to use as tracking. And since the Moose can't use positioning targets for tracking, there's really nothing that you can do about it. So moving on to the RevoPoint RANGE 2, a few general points to start with is that you don't need to plug this into an outlet. It'll get the power straight from your computer. And if you're not plugged into your computer, you can actually plug this into the external little power source that comes with it and then connect wirelessly to your computer or your smartphone. The software itself is really intuitive and easy to use. It has a lot of tools, definitely more than the 3D Maker Pro Moose and maybe more than the Creality Scan Otter as well. And project setup is really simple. When it came to scanning the engine block, the first thing I noticed is that the scanning is really laggy and slow. It basically jumps around a lot, and that really comes down to the frame rate. With the high accuracy setting, we're only capturing under 10 frames per second. With the normal mode, that might be 12 to 13, and with the high speed mode, it's only 16 frames per second, which seems really low, and you definitely notice it. As a result, the scanning process is really inefficient and it seems to pick up more errors than it would otherwise. It doesn't seem to be an issue of tracking, it seems to be more of an issue of exposure. That said, the processing in the software is really quick, which seems a bit strange to me as it seems to struggle with the actual scanning. When it came to scanning the RX7, there was really no chance of scanning it without the tracking targets. When I put the tracking targets on, it did go okay, but it just wasn't great. So next up we have the Creality CR Scan Otter, and again with this there's no need to plug it into an outlet, which is really helpful. The software again is intuitive and easy to use, it has some basic processing tools and it's really easy to get a new project set up and started. It's also easy to start and stop a scan as you need. One of the key points about the Creality scanner is it has these two sets of cameras, and that basically gives you more flexibility to be able to scan large parts with more efficiency and small parts in more detail. When it came to scanning the actual engine block itself, using the large setting was really efficient and you could scan the whole thing really quickly. However, it really seemed to be lacking resolution and the processing speed was still pretty slow. When I change to the smaller range setting, it still captures data pretty easily and smoothly, and it's what we'd expect from something like a pro level scanner. With that smaller field of view though, it is easier for errors to start to creep in, and the processing speed on that higher resolution is really slow. When it came to scanning the RX7 on that large setting, it captures data really well and efficiently, and there was no need for tracking targets. However, the processing is still quite slow and the resolution does seem to be lacking. So finally we're onto the EINSTAR, and the first thing to note is that it requires a ton of cables and it also needs quite a powerful computer to run. Past that, the software is really decent, it has most of the tools you need. Setting up a new project is pretty easy and intuitive, and processing speeds are pretty quick as well. You can pause and resume a scan pretty easily if you need to, but one little issue I found is if you start the preview function, you can't actually exit out of that without starting to scan. When it came to scanning the engine block, the experience was instantly better than the other scanners, even without the recommended computer specs. It captures a lot of data really quickly and really smoothly. However, it did just take a little bit of adjusting of the exposure to get things right. As you'd expect, when it came to scanning the RX7, things went pretty well. There was no need to use tracking targets and it scanned the whole thing pretty easily and quickly, and processing was quite fast as well. The final scan was of relatively low resolution, but you're going to get that when you're scanning a large area and if you want the processing speed to still be pretty quick. So another scan I took was of our Billet SR20 block, and I did this to be able to compare the accuracy of the four different scanners, and I did this using a software package called Geomagic Design X. So inside the software I used the auto segmentation feature to basically divide the meshes up into different regions. Then I could fit CAD primitives in the form of cylinders to the cylinders, and then use the measurement tools to be able to measure their accuracy compared to physical measurements from the real block. The bore size of the block is 89mm and the bore spacing is 97mm between each bore. The 3D Maker Pro Moose didn't actually have all the data to be able to get really good results from this test, but the errors came back in the region of about 2mm, which is not very accurate. You could get better results if you had an hour or so to spend scanning it, but I just didn't have that much time. Onto the RevoPoint RANGE 2, the scan of the billet block was actually terrible and I didn't have much data, but what was there actually returned some pretty good results, with everything being under a millimeter or so in accuracy. This isn't great, but it is better. The Creality Otter provided a much better scan and the measurements were all within 0.5mm, which is getting pretty decent. The EINSTAR provided a pretty decent scan and the bore spacing was all within 0.3mm, which is really good. However, the bores were all undersized by a millimeter or so, so the Creality Otter was actually more accurate than the EINSTAR in this case. So I just wanted to make a note here that we could spend a lot more time to get better results, but our project timelines are always going to have some type of time limitation on them. It also highlights the difference in the accuracy that we might achieve in our workshop compared to what the manufacturer shows in their specs and what they've been able to achieve in a very controlled environment. All of these scans are still very usable, we just have to factor in some tolerances. I also took the same scan with our PL3 scanner, which is more of a professional level scanner, albeit quite a bit more expensive. All of the measurements came back within 0.2mm, which just highlights that step up in accuracy to a professional level scanner. So to wrap things up, which of these scanners actually won this test? Let's start with the Moose. So this wouldn't be our recommendation unless you were on a really tight budget and couldn't justify any more expense for one of the other scanners. It is passable for scanning small areas for very basic designs. You just need to account for the extra time it might take you to get usable results. I didn't have the best experience scanning with the RevoPoint RANGE 2, and I think they've just got a little bit of development to do there on the hardware side of things. However, the software is pretty good and you can get good results if you're patient, and what I did like about it is the ability to scan wirelessly through your smartphone. Next is the Creality, and what was great about this is the flexibility that the two sets of cameras gives you between scanning small to large objects. While the resolution seemed to be lacking, the accuracy was actually really good. Finally, the most popular scanner under $1,000, and probably for good reason, is the Shinning 3D EINSTAR, and it's also our pick. It scans really efficiently, it's easy to use, and the software is probably the best. I think this is probably a bit of a result of Shinning 3D also making pro-level scanners, and you get a bit of a trickle-down effect. It is the most expensive of the group, but it is still relatively affordable for the level of scan that it produces. Hopefully this has given you some insight into a scanner that you might be able to use for your project that also fits your budget. We're always looking at ways to incorporate 3D scanning into our projects, so if there's any products that you want us to take a look at, let us know and we'll try to incorporate them into our future projects.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.